Jessica Alupo for you there, and congratulations to all the eminent women who are appointed as ministers and ministers of state in the next cabinet. Now, in an uncharacteristic wave, civil society actors are heaping commendation on President Yoweri Museveni for considering women in his next cabinet. Charity Ahimbisiwe, the executive director at Citizens Coalition for Electoral Democracy, spoke to the news exclusively, and she says this is a signal that the president's sixth term is going to be, as she put it, fruitful.
Women couldn't hide the excitement over the new cabinet, which was released last evening. Charity Ahimbisiwe, the executive director of Citizens Coalition for Electoral Democracy, argued that it's unique in nature for Uganda to have the first female prime minister, Robina Nabanja.
Because the biggest number of people on this cabinet, especially the full ministers, are women. I think the president has listened to the fact that we've been saying we are not second-rate citizens. We also have something to offer, and I think he has done well. On this one, I really, really congratulate President Museveni. I congratulate him for having taken a true decision in terms of the Constitution. Article 33 talks about equal representation of men and women in decision-making positions. And if you look at all the protocols to which Uganda is signatory, international and African or regional, they also talk about gender parity or 50-50 representation of men and women.
In the same cabinet, Jessica Alupo replaced Edward Chiwanuka Sekandi as vice president. This will be the second time in the history of Uganda for the country to have a female vice president after Speciosa Wandera Kaziwe. She, however, observed that women have a big task ahead to prove to the country that they can deliver.
Vice president is second person in government after the president. I think that when a woman takes such a position, it inspires other women who haven't made it to where Jessica Alupo has made it. In the history of Uganda, we only had Speciosa Kaziwe. Remember that even the United States has only recently had the first time they had a woman for a vice president. So this is distinct. This has set Uganda's pace extremely high. It is a totally different bar. The standard has been raised above. So taking those key positions, prime minister, leader of government business, we've not seen a prime minister who is a woman. This is the first time we get a woman. Nabanja comes on. I think this is distinct.
On the light note, Ahimbisiwe asked the public, especially people on social media, to stop being comic over the appointment of the Kakumiro woman member of parliament as the prime minister. She assured them that Nabanja has the potential.
English doesn't matter, and I think that's, for me, that is the strength of this appointment. The strength of this appointment is that if you remember the State of the Nation address, the president came and said he was going to employ the children of the rich. And people took to social media, all over radio stations, TV, and said, look, why only the children of the rich, even the poor, want to make it there? Nabanja does not represent the children of the rich. No. She represents people who have struggled to make it to where they are. And if she has struggled to make it to where she is, she inspires those who are still struggling. She inspires the bracket that the president didn't talk about in the State of the Nation address. For me, this is a celebration throughout, and this mockery should stop.
Rebecca Kadaga, who was also defeated by Jacob Olanya for the post of Speaker of Parliament, has been appointed as the first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister for East African Community Affairs. The activists have challenged Kadaga to bury the election hatchet and work together with the Prime Minister Nabanja for the good of the country. Story was compiled by Jaliet Namoya for the news in Kampala.